Hi, this is Jamie Humphries, and welcome to another review here in Guitar Interactive magazine. And for this review, I am proud to present the Marshall YJM 100 watt head. Now, this is the long awaited and anticipated signature amp, courtesy of Marshall Amplification, who have had a long standing relationship now with the Swedish Shredmeister Yngwie Malmsteen. Yngwie's been using Marshall's, well, pretty much for his entire career, a combination of a Strat and a Marshall, very much like Ritchie Blackmore, one of his big heroes. And over years of experimenting with different gear, different combinations, and then working with the guys at Marshall, he has come up with, or they have come up with, should I say, his ultimate head. And I have to say that this is well worth the wait, and probably one of the best signature amps that I've ever come across. If my humble and meager opinion is anything to go by. The first thing that I like about this amp, and the first thing that you probably find slightly surprising, and no disrespect to Yngwie, because I am a huge fan of Yngwie, everything to do with him, great guitar player, great vibrato, great technique, flawless, amazing tone, everything, and have been a fan for years. And Yngwie gets a little bit of a bad rap when it comes to his on and off stage antics. And I have to say, for someone with such a big personality, I think is a polite way to put it. Like I said, this is I'm not meaning to be disrespectful here. The amp is very understated, and I really like that. It's based on an old 1959 Marshall, four input, very traditional, big cabinet. It's quite weighty. If we look at the controls on the floor, all you can just see is a very, very subtle YMJ. There's no fancy graphics or anything, just very, very, very subtle. So, you know, if you're looking for a real sort of traditional old school style, you know, early 70s classic Marshall, then it's got a few little tricks up its sleeve, then this is definitely the amp for you. Running across the front, controls very straightforward. We have a presence control, bass control, the mid-range, the treble, and then we have two volumes here, volume one and volume two. And then basically they work on the different inputs. We have different, like a high and low sensitivity input. I'm basically running the guitar into input one and then channel jumping the two together, which enables me to blend the two volume controls here to tailor my sound and tailor my tone. Up this end, we have the indicator that tells us that the light is on, the amp is on, should I say, when the light is on. Then we have the on-off control and the standby. Something I want to say about this amp, when you're plugging into it, it really feels quality, like pushing the jack sockets in, it feels sturdy, it feels well made. It feels like a, you know, something that's going to stand the test of time and some gigs. Now the secrets appear on the back of this amplifier, where we have a series of other controls. And this is the really cool thing about it. It's an old school amplifier, yet with modern features that you'd expect, but it's retaining that classic look, and the front of the amp isn't cluttered. On the back, we have a control for a boost. So that literally is like a gain control and a volume, so you can set the level of the boost. We also have a noise gate control. So when you kick the boost in, you can adjust how heavy or light the noise gate is or how sensitive it is. We also have a control for reverb, which is a studio quality digital reverb that you can blend in again with the volume control. We have an effects loop, which obviously you didn't have on these originally. All of those features so far that I've mentioned can be accessed from the little controller here. And surprisingly enough, doesn't use some weird or wonderful plug that if you break, you're screwed. It's just a regular quarter inch jack. And it operates this four button foot pedal that I have down here. Also, a nice little touch is the way that it almost has like labels stuck on it with handwritten boost, gate, reverb, and effects loop. I think that's pretty cool. So it looks like your roadie's written them on there. And you have some indicators on the top there that tell you when each effect has been engaged. These can also be controlled on the back of the amplifier as well with a series of buttons, again, with little indicators on. The amplifier, in terms of valves, has three EL34 valves in it and four ECC83 valves, preamp valves. You can see there are four little red lights on the back, which basically indicate whether you've got a fault on your power amp valves and which valve it is. There's also a button on the back for biasing your valves. You can do it yourself. There's another button that cuts the amplifier instantly from 100 watts down to 50 watts. And then the other really cool feature is the power reduction, and you can run the amp way down low. So we had the amp earlier on when we were testing it. We had it really cooking, extremely loud, and the sound crew here were like, mate, you're blasting out of the amp cupboard where we have the cabinet set up. You're going to have to turn it down. Is that going to affect the sound? I was like, no, not at all. Just turn that control on the back, and we still had all that gain cooking, and we just lowered the output. So it's a very, very versatile amp, great for live. If you're powering a gig and you're not miking up, you're not going to have any problem being heard with this amp. Again, if you want it to be a little bit more controlled for working, for recording, or just, you know, if you're miking the amp up as well, you don't want to be really, really loud. It's a sound man's nightmare to be too loud. You can obviously get the desired tone, get the valves cooking, get everything doing its thing that you want it to, and then just drop the level down, and the whole level of the amp will come down, and you can still retain the tone that you've dialed in. Anyway, let's run through some of the sounds. For this, I'm using a humbucker guitar, an Ernie Ball Music Man Reflex guitar, which I've gone for this guitar because it's a chambered body. It's got a slightly sort of woody tone about it. At the moment, if I just turn down, or we'll turn up the volumes actually. Can hear as I turn up each volume how the amp starts to crunch a little more. So your basic core sound. I can back that down if I turn the volume down. If I go onto the neck pickup, I can get some nice Woody Hendrix sort of tones. Go single coil on it. So at the moment, it's acting pretty much like an old school Marshall, how you would expect it to act. But obviously, we've got the luxury of having it at a level that's not, you know, uncontrollable in a studio environment. Okay, the first thing that I'm going to kick in is the reverb. So studio quality digital reverb. Reverb off. With it back on, you can hear it's got a nice sort of air about it, but it's not doesn't have that kind of non high quality sound to it that you get with spring reverbs. Whenever I've had an amp with spring reverb, it's just off. A lot of the other amp manufacturers are also offering this feature, so I'm pleased to see it on this amplifier, because it does add something to the sound, I think, that you can have studio quality reverb and give it that room sort of feel. Okay, now we've got the effects loop, which obviously that's not going to do anything right now because I'm not running any effects, but if you had an effects unit in there, you can just kick that in and it activates the effects loop. So, you know, if you've got reverb or delay or chorus, obviously you don't need reverb now, we've got digital reverb built into the amp. Now moving up to the other end, we have the boost control. Now I have set this to my kind of desired tastes. So also another interesting thing, we've got the noise gate, which we can kick in just to make things, everything nice and quiet. It's not really going to be doing much right now because the amp's not set that to that higher gain. As soon as we kick the boost in, the noise gate comes on automatically as well, which is kind of a cool feature. So you're not trying to, you know, sort of tap dance too much to control the amount of noise. If I kick that now, the amp is still quiet. And you can hear going between those two settings, so with the boost. We can also turn the noise gate off as well once it's kicked in with the boost. You can now hear that we're starting to get some hiss. No more hiss. So a very, very useful function, but also at the same time controllable. You're not stuck with having it on. In terms of a crunchy tone, it has that Yngwie quality. You know, that nice kind of snap and bite to the notes, a nice definition as well. Now, when I'm picking, alternate picking there, you can hear, it's not mushy, it's got a definition to the note. So very, very, very controllable. And again, with the, with the guitar backed off. At that point, it's probably, that's where the noise gate is maybe something that you have to work on. Insert, if you have too much of the too high a sensitivity set on the gate, then you're gonna run into problems of it choking the notes off. So I haven't worked enough with the amp to get it at a level whereby if I've still got it with the boost on, see there, you're hearing the gate kicking in and out, whereas if I take the gate off, okay, so there we have the layout and a few tones that you can get from the amp. It's going to give you more of that classic hard rock metally sound. It's not a very modern high gain sound in terms of it being very scooped. It's that classic Yngwie tone. I personally feel that this is one of the best amplifiers that I've played through in a long time. I think this is a very, very good amplifier. It's feature laden, it's classic looking, it's understated. And even though I'm always a little bit dubious of signature models in anything, because you are effectively playing something that's built for someone else and it's someone else's choices. And you know, if you're anything like myself, I like to have my own choices in things and play things and use things for certain reasons that I feel are beneficial to my needs as a guitar player. But I think that the Yngwie amp has got something for everyone and is definitely, you know, not just a, you know, a pretty fascia with some graphics or a logo and someone's signature. You know, this amp has got a lot to offer. So if you are in the market for something classic, with a few tricks up its sleeve and something that would definitely surprise surprise you, then this is the amplifier for you. Is it cheap? No, it's not overly expensive, but you know, it's not a you know, obviously getting into the higher end of things. It comes with the foot switch, which is great. It comes with a very attractive red cover, and also you get a certificate as well, which I think is a really nice touch. So all in all, if you're a fan of Yngwie, then this is going to be a must. And if you're like me, if you just like kind of old school classic amps, but either A, can't afford a really expensive old amp, or B, even if you had one, would it really do the things that we're used to having now? You know, would it have the features like noise gate? Would it have effects loops? No, it wouldn't. It would be temperamental, very romantic to use, but incredibly noisy. Whereas this amplifier captures all of those qualities that we like, but puts it into the, you know, the modern age with really effective, you know, modern modifications to it, but at the same time still retaining that classic tone.